What up, everybody? Just had to drink from my water. And welcome to my Doge of Venice art stream. Before we get started, you're probably wondering what it was you just listened to. That is titled, that song that just played, it's called the Doc Ock Suite. It is from the score for Spider-Man 2 from 2004. One of the best theme songs for a comic book movie character ever. Really has that 60s Spider-Man vibe to it too, with the bongo drums. Of course, that was Danny Elfman that did that. So yeah, Doc Ock Suite, Danny Elfman, Spider-Man 2. You've probably heard it. So, I'll give you guys a few moments to get in here. Also, what I'm listening to in the background is not Vaporwave this time. I saw that there's something called Chiptune. Chiptune Music Stream. So I had to try it out. It does sound pretty cool. What's up, Jade Mirror? What's up, Luga? What's up, Ken Spiracy? What's up, Caleb Land? What's up, Jimmy Stiff Fingers? Zeranx, Bada. So, I don't really have any goals for today artistically, but I'm gonna try and just like draw some faces. I want to come up with a couple more cops and things like that. Maybe just other supporting characters. Danny Elfman of, I think, of Little Shop of Horror fame, if I'm not mistaken. Danny Elfman was better known for his, he was in the band Oingo Boingo. I think he was a lead singer. If you want to see him back then, he's really weird looking, but I mean, appropriate for the time of the 80s. The big hit song for that band that I know of was Dead Man's Party. But I know there was other stuff. Like, yeah, I don't know. So, this is a Bombshell. That's the cop. Oh, I guess I should show you guys that I did some more refined lines for this cop. I couldn't resist. I was gonna like do it on a stream, but then like last night I had like 10 minutes or 15 minutes to kill, and so I just knocked it out. I was like passing the time. So I chose the Spider-Man 2 song not only because I love it, but also because I started playing the Spider-Man game on PlayStation 4. I didn't think it was gonna suck me in, but holy shit. I wanna go back to New York and fight crime, but I gotta work. So I'll reward myself later with some Spider-Man on the PS4. And I don't know if you guys are following me on Xanamaru on my other YouTube channel. I don't do much there, but I might stream that. I don't know. If that's interesting to you guys, if not, I get it. So, anyway. Let me make another layer and do some sketching. What's up, Michael Keller? What's up, Charles? So, let me see. I'm just going to draw some heads. Oh, I don't like this pencil for sketching. I'm gonna change it to this one. Alright. I'm just going to sketch some heads. I don't know what I'm doing with this right now. Just coming up with, more ideas, I guess. Any particular types of cop face, like the hard scene, some cop wears, what? Oh, like some, like the hard scene, some wars cop face, the newbie cop face. Well, I'm gonna try and make them look like a variety of people from different walks of life. More or less. So I just had this thought of one right now. Maybe he's got a nose like this, and kind of a weak chin. This might not even be a cop. I'm just drawing a face right now. So maybe I won't make this a cop. I don't know yet. Because I don't want them to look all weak, but I want to do... I was thinking like a skinny one. So I'm just drawing a collar right now. This might not become a cop. I'm just drawing a face. Draw at least one ahegao. I don't know if I could do that justice. My standards in ahegao are really high. And let's see, that's that. Like an older guy, but maybe still a cop. Or a watchmaker? Yeah. You know, a lot of people would think that. I don't know what this is going to be. Hold on. How about these like aviators? I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. I'm not married to any of this. I'm just drawing it right now. So he's a cool stuffed suit. It could be. That doesn't look too bad, does it? He looks like a lawyer, this guy. Although I don't know. I could get rid of the glasses too. I could, let's see. I'll come back to that. Matrix Man? Yeah, Agent Smith. A G-Man, right? Give him a mustache and he looks like my old bookkeeping professor. Objection! Yeah. He has the nose, certainly. Let's try a different face. I want a detective too, so maybe a more kind of hard-boiled type. this. I'm gonna do it like this way. Those kinds of ears. Go. Pixel noises. Does Bombshell have a sidekick or roommate? No. No sidekicks. I you know what? I was never crazy about the idea of sidekicks. Because it was just like a ploy to get kids to buy the books, right? I never liked the idea of sidekicks. I mean, sometimes it can work, but... Nah. I'm not a big fan of that. I'd rather have duos. Like Power Man and Iron Fist, for example. Smoke curling over the hat brim. I don't know if these are real songs or not. It's just like a mix. But if, you know what? If it was, it would make sense. I noticed that the chiptune thing is really in right now. But the funny thing is that a lot of the stuff from like actual 8-bit games, they couldn't actually sound this sophisticated. There was a limit on what you could do back then. And when the 16-bit consoles came out, they moved away from the chiptune stuff because they were able to make, to give it a little bit more of a synthesized sound. If you look at like ActRaiser, Contra, I think it was Super Contra, Super Castlevania 4, even the Mega Man 7. It didn't have chiptune music so much. It was more like, how to explain it. It was 16-bit music didn't sound like this, is what I'm saying. At the end of the day. Are you a fan of any anti-heroes? Yeah. Chip step. Oh my god, that doesn't sound good. And refine the face shape. Yeah. I like that. It makes him look a little older. Okay. I like this handsome fellow. Thank you. Bitcore for the win. I've been thinking of the Punisher, and although they say they don't have any superpowers, I suspect they can retroactively make anyone they kill a criminal. This sounds really familiar. But it's not. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave this for now. I gotta think about, actually. Yeah, I don't know if any of this music is gonna be from anything or if it's gonna be all original content. That's one of the reasons why I chose it, because I'm curious. Let me see. I need another face. Let me think about this for a second. I got another cop. I'm gonna get a female cop. Make her a redhead. You have a thing with, like... Did you ask me about redheads yesterday? Female cops is a thing I cannot comprehend. let me see. Well, she's gonna be wearing a hat. Because that's important. So. then, I guess I could put a little ponytail in the back. Give her a scar. Nah, don't do that. She needs something else though. Let me see. Let's see what you guys are saying. Looks kind of like Jerry Lynn Ryan. The one who played 7 of 9. This woman does? Wow, that's a lot to extrapolate from, like, such a simple little doodle. Is this music or a siren in the background? It's chiptune. It's a chiptune mix. People really do enjoy the redheads. I've seen it in the seedier parts of the interwebs. I think that redheads in art are really overrepresented, especially in women. They love the idea of giving a woman red hair, and I'm tempted to do it too, right? A lot, but I'm not going to. I have one redhead character, and I think that's all I'm gonna do. I think that red hair should be as unusual as it is, unless, you know, the female characters are getting their getting hair dye, which a lot of times does happen. A lot of times you meet a girl with red hair and it's not her color. Just like blondes. Natural blondes are slightly more unusual, but natural redheads are very unusual. Is the female cop about the job or a softer type? If former, the hair might be too long. Well, I thought it would just like go to like right here, like this. So it's not that she's like super committed to the job. Maybe she's more of a desk jockey. I don't know yet. I mean, I have a plan for her as well as the other cop in the story that I want to do. She needs cowbell. Yeah. She has similar face features. Okay. Brian, you're breaking my heart. Perhaps some freckles. Nope, not doing freckles because, again, I want them to be a little bit unusual. Here, I'll show you something. We just talked about this, right? I did. Where is it? Is it? Where is it? Where's my. So when I did the roller derby girl sketches, right? I already gave this one freckles. So I think that, I mean, I know freckles are not rare, but I don't want to go and do, I don't want to make that too common. I only want to do it sometimes. So I've already done freckles. I think that this girl, I'm thinking about making her, thinking about the demographics of California, I'm thinking about making her Hispanic, but I could also make her Asian or a mix, maybe Filipino or something. Are Filipinos relatively common in California? A tired look is good. I could put some bags under her eyes. Overworked, yeah, I like that. Overworked and underappreciated is the thing I'm going for here. Freckles are perfection. That's enough freckles. Yeah, I don't want to do too many freckles. But I want her to be slightly husky and tired looking. Cause like, you know, not a, the thing is, I see this a lot too in comics, especially. Like, they make the female cops, like, they still, like, have model bodies. And when I see cops that are female, and I do see a lot of female cops in Chicago, they're always, you know, big women. Like, there are some small ones, but big. Not fat. I mean, like, you can tell they're muscular or they're just wearing a lot of body armor, but in the face you can see it. Not huge. Just, like, you know, sturdy. That's the word I want. Asians are, but I don't know if Filipinos are more represented in Cali. Yeah, so I might make her, like, an Asian mix or something. I don't know. If I do the race thing, I basically do it based on what's in the area, what's the demographic, what's the likelihood, and then go with that, you know? Not like we need more representation of X. I mean, the majority of the people in my book are going to be white because the majority of the country is white. But there will be people of other races also, right? Built for work, yeah. Who's Detective Rosa? Is that just what you had in mind? Let's see. Now I'm going to draw the police commissioner. So let me think about that for a second. Gotta be careful that you don't just draw another Commissioner Gordon. So, I gotta think about how to make a police commissioner look good. I got one. It's gonna be male. Because I'm not stupid. I know what the odds are. I think this would work. I know the police commissioners are, former cops, right? So, could be black. I think a black guy would be okay. Old. Start with a black guy, no Commissioner Gordon possible, yeah. Give him a long face. No, I thought about that, but artistic black face, yeah. Bald or gray haired? I was thinking about bald, but now I'm thinking I was thinking completely bald, like shaved head, but maybe I can do something like this. You want it to be somebody who, like, in their prime was, like, you know, probably, badass. Given afro. Yeah. No afro. Shiny bald head. No, that's Samuel L. Jackson. I'm gonna also do one other thing. I'm gonna give him a pipe. Is a pipe okay? Do you think that's all right? Maybe a different kind of pipe though, like one of these. I'm thinking Morgan Freeman hair reads instantly as fatherly. I'm inclined to like this guy from his face so far. Yeah. Pipe for the crack cocaine? No. Definitely has a Samuel beard. Yeah, like a beard. And with strong features underneath, right? And then like, I was thinking glasses. No, he's like getting old, right? He just works a desk now. But he still wants to like help out, do his part. He wants to protect the city. Hold on. His hairline is a little bit too, Actually, now that I'm looking at it, does it look a little bit too much like Granddad from the Boondocks? I might have to look at that. I don't want to confuse people here. Hold on. Oh, look at those fluffy brows. Yes. Let's take a look. It kind of does, doesn't it? Kinda. Not really, though. He has a receding hairline, but not the, beard. And his eyebrows are thinner. And, the receding hairline doesn't go as far back. It's not all the way back. It's, like, up top. Full head of hair for him. I might do that. Let's look at Morgan Freeman these days. All right, let's see. What you guys think about that? Give me the type that changes in the sunlight. Yeah, 10 out of 10 would smash. Does he need the glasses? The eyebrows have a lot of character already. Yeah, I was thinking the same. Now he looks weird. Well, hold on a second. I gotta respond to a message. He looks fine. God. Bigger eyes. Let's get rid of the pipe for now. It feels extra. I'll come back to that. If I need to, I'll just redraw it. All right. What if I got rid of the mustache and I just made it a chin strap? He's almost like a black Abraham Lincoln, but with white hair. I could base him on somebody real too. I could look up pictures of like George Washington Carver or some shit. All right, let's zoom in a little bit more and try to like, what I wanted to do, something like this. Steely look. Too. That usually helps when they're like looking back. And a bag under the eye and some crow's feet. Like some bags around the top as well. Sounds too Amish. No eye patches. I could also do one other thing. I could change the head shape completely and then try to add on the features. Let's do another little doodle here and just look. So let's say I had made his head like really round. Instead, I don't know if this would do a lot, but I'm experimenting. This might be too old, though. Okay. But it's given me some thoughts. I'm always happy to get old people faces. It's given me some thoughts, though. That Yoda. It's giving me ideas. So now that I've drawn this, it's communicating some things to me. Like, I'm not gonna go with this, but it's giving me some ideas about this that I want to change. So I like the eyes on this old guy. I like the ears. And I kind of like the mouth a bit. Like, it's kind of like, but I think that the mouth is too old for this dude. So what I'm going to do is I am going to make some changes. Let me see if this is going to work. Get rid of this muscular neck. Let's try to... Okay, so this is where the eyes would be. Right? And I want to exaggerate the bags under the eyes a lot, as well as over them. I want to enlarge the ears, because I think that when people get older, it seems like the ears... So he's not gonna be super handsome, like, but maybe somebody who used to be. I'm gonna get rid of this mouth. Do it again. Wiki article I saw says strong Asian population in San Francisco, 21% Chinese, San Jose, 10% Vietnamese. Overall, Filipinos are 3.9%. Okay, well, maybe I'll just do Chinese. Like a Chinese mix. Which, Chinese mixed with Hispanic looks pretty Filipino, so. Old dude looks like a testicle with a face. We'll have the chin jut out a little bit, too. Somebody suggested a broken nose. I think I will do that. I still like the fluffy eyebrows, so we're gonna give him those. Samuel better. I like this. Ye olde vampire eyes. And I'm not going to give him a beard, but I am going to give him... He kind of has a chimpanzee head now. We are all apes, my man. I am going to give him sideburns to kind of suggest that he's like a dude from the 70s. Cuz I think people who were, yeah, they're if they were like in their prime in the 70s. They're pretty old right now, right? So. For some reason, he reminds me of Don Cornelius. I thought about giving him like gray. It's gonna be white hair with like streaks of black in it. But I don't know. I haven't decided on that yet. I might have to come back to that. Gray with mutton chops. Yeah, these are mutton chops right here. I'll draw them on this side too. There we go. Kind of dignified bifocals, like little glasses like this. Nah. I think this is cool. I'll give him a broken nose. I'll do a more refined version later. How old is he? I was thinking 65 or so. So like, it's 2018. So then he would be like close to 20 years old when he was on the force in the 70s. It might even like the late 70s into like the early 80s. 70 at least. Yeah, but retirement age is 65, right? So maybe he's like right on the edge. Pretty sure retirement age is 65. Square ones? Yeah, I might do that. Actually, I'm really happy that I continued to refine it because I like this face. I like really strong faces. This old man looks, I like him too, but he's gonna go. Sorry, but thank you, sir, for your service. It was thanks to your help that I was able to get this other dude. Now step aside. It's their time. Anyway, you know, I didn't get a it's been an hour and I didn't get a chance to to discuss the thing I wanted it to talk about. I feel kind of bad about that. But I'll go through it really quick. So, The Tonight Show canceled Norm Macdonald's appearance because he had criticisms of the Me Too movement. If you guys know that. We are not apes, we are hominins. Hominins. The old man kicked the bucket. Yep, he was erased. Kind of pisses me off, this Norm... Well, kind of. I mean, like, it shows that... It shows that there is no endgame with the outraged mob. You know, they just want to ruin people. Like, so Norm Macdonald's appearance on The Tonight Show was taken off, and people are saying, what's the big deal? It's just The Tonight Show, who gives a shit? It's like the idea, though. Like, he didn't rape or touch anyone. All he did was basically criticize the Me Too movement for going too far, and because of that, people think that he's being insensitive, and so he shouldn't appear on The Tonight Show. So what's going to happen? He's supposed to have his own show on Netflix. Do you think that he's still going to have a show on Netflix after this? And the only thing he did was criticize the Me Too movement? Henry Cavill got into a lot of shit because he had basically said, I don't want to be alone with a woman. You know, it's too risky. I'm not going to date right now. And he got shit for it. So, like, the thing is, I guess the point I wanted to make about this Norm Macdonald thing is, it's not enough that the Me Too movement is going after people who, you know, have been, sexually untoward, like Harvey Weinstein, who, as far as I can tell, the only thing he did was he I mean, like, aside from any actual instances of abuse, assault, or rape, he has mostly asked women if they want to be famous and to suck his dick or whatever to do it, and they have mostly agreed. And then they turn around later and say, well, I didn't really want to do that. It's kind of gross, but, you know, and they do it after they become famous. And they're treating like a voluntary exchange of services as though it's something that's only the man's fault. It's bad enough that the Me Too movement is just going after that. It's bad enough that the Me Too movement is going after people who have only done weird sexual things that aren't rape or sexual assault. The case is Louis C.K. He basically asked girls if he could jerk off, and they said okay, gave him the thumbs up, and he did it, and now he's a bad guy. We don't even think about the fact that it was fucking, you know, consensual, and these people didn't make a big stink out of it. They didn't fight back. They didn't do anything except go along with it and then decide later that it wasn't right. Okay? It's bad enough that the Me Too movement ignores instances where women are the perpetrators or even defend them, as is the case with Asia Argento and Jimmy Bennett. Is it Jimmy Bennett? I think it is, yeah. And then, like, they, Rose McGowan calls for, let's be gentle, let's do due process. Meanwhile, Harvey Weinstein and Louis C.K., you know? But now, they're going after people who didn't commit any crimes, didn't touch anyone, didn't get Me Too'd at all, and they want to ruin them for actually criticizing Me Too. This hole has no bottom. It's going to be to the point where they will, and they don't have a plan, because if Norm loses his show, Louis C.K. lost his show or something, right? So he's going to be difficult to get, he's not going to get work very easily. Norm is going to probably end up losing work. Roseanne lost work, right? All this shit. And they think that this is like what's best. That it basically, there's no redemption arc for any of these people. Louis C.K. can't make a comeback for at least, you know, 10 years or something. Like when people, maybe it's blown over or if it implodes on itself. But there's no plan. And so, like, what if these people became homeless? Are they now going to become a drain on our society? Because they can't get work because nobody wants to hire them. Because rapes and misogyny and stuff. You know? Where does it end with these people? There's no end. It's fucked up. And they shouldn't be apologizing. Did you see Adam Baldwin share an article that has Rose McGowan, one of the 12 people, regretting Me Too? No, I didn't see that, but I'll look it up. I mean, well, you should, because this is the monster you created. Okay, on top of that, something else that happened. This is not about men's issues, but this is something that I care about. Do you guys know Brandon Straka? Brandon Straka is a gay hairstylist that started the hashtag walkaway movement. The walkaway movement, I don't know if it's a movement, the walkaway hashtag is basically people walking away from the Democratic Party. People who are explaining that they're no longer going to become voting for the left. And their stories as to why. And he's one of them. Because he bought in all their bullshit, right? Now, this doesn't mean they're becoming Republicans, just to be clear. This just means they're no longer Democrats. They're walking away, right? And the walkaway hashtag has been actually really, really huge, even though Twitter has been doing its best to make sure that it doesn't get seen as much as it should. And Brandon Straka has been making appearances all over the place, okay? Brandon Straka has received a 30-day ban from Facebook on Wednesday because he posted a link to his recent interview on InfoWars. He posted a link to an interview he did on InfoWars and they banned him for it. This is coming, strangely enough, like 2 months away from the midterm elections here in the States. I don't think that's an accident. Now, I know that Facebook, Twitter, Google, all kinds of places right? They have problems with InfoWars. But this is really about Straka, not InfoWars. And there's nothing in it, as far as I know, that should be ban-worthy. But this is what happened. Straka said the suspension came ahead of his planned march in Washington and cuts him off from over 180,000 members of the walkaway campaign. This is what he said about it. I'm devastated right now. Walkaway campaign is a grassroots movement. We don't have corporate sponsors. We don't have backers. We are raising the money and the awareness for our event ourselves. We use GoFundMe to raise money, and today's Facebook took away my ability to communicate with the 180,000 members of the campaign leading up to the march. So he has a march planned, or had, and I think he was promoting it on InfoWars, and he got zucked. Yeah. That is, that should bother you guys a lot. Whether you agree with him or not, this is a problem. You know? This is a big problem. And it pisses me off. I mean, you know, he had his march coming up, and I bet it, I have no doubt in my mind it's because of the midterms, and they were just looking for something to get him on, because the walkaway thing is huge. It really is. All right, one more thing, and then I gotta go. So, you guys heard about Henry Cavill leaving, possibly leaving the DC Expanded Universe, which means Superman is leaving. They're talking about Superman leaving. And Jade Mirror says, I've never used Facebook or anything like that. Yeah, well, that you use YouTube, because here you are. And you use Google, most likely. And maybe Twitter. Bookburnings are super gross for me. Well, did you hear about Roosh V and Amazon removing all of his books from their site because Huffington Post applied pressure? I mean, it's the only thing that seems to be the reason, anyway. Because they supposedly he broke their rules or something. Even though there's a lot of other shit on there that's probably way more questionable than a book about a guy bragging about his sexual conquests. So Henry Cavill is... There was a rumor that he was supposed to be leaving DC or Warner Brothers Studios and would no longer be playing Superman. And it came because they were talking about a possible cameo appearance of Superman in the new upcoming Shazam movie. Which looks like a lot of fun, by the way. But as it turns out, there is no like substantial evidence to suggest that that is the case. Now, the Warner Brothers Studios is focusing, supposedly, on female-led superhero movies. And the reasoning behind it, I suspect, is that the DC Universe movies have all been pretty awful, with the exception of Wonder Woman, which was actually pretty good. I wouldn't say it's great, but it was pretty good. And I think that they think that the fact that Wonder Woman is female might be the reason that it was a success, but that's not really the reason. The reason was that Wonder Woman was done well, for the most part. I mean, there was some feminist shit in there, and the ending sucked, but the other stuff was okay. And meanwhile, Batman v Superman, Man of Steel, Suicide Squad, and Justice League were all trash. Yes, I said it. They were all trash. They were all cynical, like moody, low energy, badly shot, overly CG'd trash, and badly written too. And that's the real reason they failed. It's not because, you know, people went flocking to the theaters because Wonder Woman was female. Because then that would, by that logic, the original Supergirl from the 1980s and the Catwoman movie starring Halle Berry would have been successes. And they were both really bad. So, I think that, but what it comes down to is that it's not true. It's a rumor. Superman is still, from what I know, he's still around. They're making a Supergirl movie, sure. The reason why he's not going to be in Shazam is because of scheduling conflicts. But as far as I know, Henry Cavill is still Superman. And so, you know, it's a rumor. It's not confirmed. Let's put it that way. As a side note, Ben Affleck is still going to be Batman. Also, he's committed to the role. So if you hate that, then too bad. That's basically it. I wanted to bring those things up So yeah, we got lots of interesting news. Like I said, Henry Cavill, as far as I know, is not leaving the role of Superman. I think they need to get, if you want a good Superman movie, you need a good Superman character. If you want to look at the best Superman, you got to go back and watch Christopher Reeve's Superman 1, and then try to figure out how they got it right and what you're doing wrong. Despite all of the differences in technology, it was a different time back then, and that shows in the film. Watch the original Superman. It feels completely different. Okay? Also, the walkaway founder thing with him being banned from Facebook is fucked up. Roosh V's books getting taken off of Amazon is fucked up. And it will, if that trend continues, it will lead to MRA books being pulled off of Amazon because of the same line of reasoning that was used to remove Roosh V. Okay? Norm MacDonald's appearance canceled. Also, it's not huge, but it's kind of fucked up, and it shows that Me Too has no end, and they don't care who they crush, but they will crush everyone that stands in their way of progress. So, that is it for me. Tell me what you guys think about the stories. Tell me what you think about what's going on so far with the Bombshell stuff. I will try to do more tomorrow. Every little bit. I feel like I'm moving very confidently towards a final product that I hope you guys will enjoy. If you like, basically like classically told fun superhero stories about people stopping bad guys. That's all I want to do. I don't want to make a political statement. I don't want to do any of that. I want to tell good stories. So, Let me know what you guys think. I look forward to seeing your comments. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit notifications. And I'll talk to you guys very soon.